everyone. Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on this look. Let me zoom in a little bit and refocus. I really didn't know which direction I was going in when I first started this. I knew I wanted to do sort of like a grungy, darker look than I normally do. So I decided to do this thing here. I really wanted to use circle lenses, but my eyes were just not having it today, so whatever, I ditched those. So just kind of a smoky, soft, wing-shaped eye with a pop of color in the corner there. And I used these real messy crisscross lashes that I got off of eBay. A little bit long for my liking, but whatever, they serve the purpose and add to that grungy look. And for the rest of the face, I did a little bit heavier contouring than I normally do. I really wanted to do a dark lip like Black Dahlia from OCC, but it was just a lot going on because I'm not used to this dark of an eye and this much contouring, and with the dark lips it just seemed like a little bit much. So I just opted for a nude glossy lip. I was also watching Scott Pilgrim while I was filming this, so that's why I see the earbud in my ear the whole time. And I don't know how well I was paying attention to if I was in focus or not, so my apologies if there's a little bit of blur going on, but hopefully you'll get the gist of it. Alright, so if you like this look, keep on watching. So I've already got Urban Decay Primer Potion on my eyes, and I've already done my foundation, and I'm going to start with Skimp from Urban Decay. And that's just going on the inner third of my eyes, I would say. And then I'm going to go in with Sin, which is cool-ish toned light brown, lots of frost in it. And that's going right beside Skim. And then I'm really tempted to do some color here. Let's go for this indigo-ish color. And that's going in the outer corner here. So these matte Inglot colors tend to be a little bit patchy for the first little bit that you're applying them, but you know, just keep working it and it will even out and blend out really nicely. And really pack on the color here because I want it to be quite strong. I'm going to bring that a little bit up into the crease. And I'm going to take that original brush I was using to just blend it out a little bit, just to blend the colors together. So when you have the bright pop color, you can use whatever color you like. Whenever you have a bright color, how you like it, we're going to go in with a medium matte brown and just go around the crease to help blend out that crease color a little bit and darken it up a little. At the moment, I'm really liking taking my crease color up towards my brow on the inner half a little bit, like very, very slightly. I feel like it opens my eyes a little bit more. And at the moment, I'm really loving dark gold, bronzy colors, so I'm going to go in with Urban Decay Baked Quintessential Summer Color under my eyes, and this is going right close to the lash line. And I'm bringing it a little farther down in the outer corner. And when I started doing this look, I was really feeling doing like a darker eyeliner all around my eye and doing some intense lashes. So I'm going to go in with my Inglot matte black color. And I'm using a shadow instead of a liquid liner or something for this because I don't want it to be as crisp a line as it could be. I want it to be a little bit smudged out, a little bit smoky. And so I'm going to do that around the top and bottom lash line. And for some reason, just because of the way the creases in my eyes are, the eyeliner on this eye always looks thicker than it does on this eye. So I feel like I'm going to have to even that out a little bit. I'll make this one a little bit proportionally thicker to make them look even. And I'm blending that into the purple a little bit, just to have a smooth transition between the black liner and the purpley indigo color. And of course I'm getting fallout everywhere. Okay, and then after you've got your liner all around your eyes, it's a bit grungy looking, and that's kind of what I'm going for. And I'm going with a flesh toned color as a brow highlight. It's pretty much almost the exact same color as my skin tone, so it's just gonna help to blend out the crease color and bring it down a little bit. So I've heard of this trick for putting on false lashes, where you apply the glue right to your lash line instead of onto the lashes themselves. And I guess I'm going to try it out today. I'm a little bit nervous, but I guess we'll see how this goes. I'm gonna take an art brush, one that I don't care too much about, and apply it like eyeliner, and we'll see how it goes. And I'm going to make sure that I really get the outer corner well as the inner corner. So that looks pretty ridiculous right now, but at least it'll be pretty easy to tell when it's getting tacky, because you'll be able to see exactly when it starts to go a little bit translucent. And I'll be back in a sec when this dries a little bit. I've cut down my lashes to size. I'm using these super sort of messy crisscross lashes. We shall see how this goes. This is very hard to do one-handed. I don't actually have a mirror that stands itself up, so I will be back. So surprisingly, that method didn't work out horribly. I still feel like I'd prefer the traditional method of applying falsies. I'm not a master at it yet because I barely ever wear false lashes, but it's getting there. It's good enough. Yeah, clearly, I really like how this one looks better than this one. The glue's still drying anyways. So while that's still drying, I'm gonna do the rest of my face. I feel like maybe doing some contour today. I'm gonna take this medium brown matte shadow, the same one I use for my crease. I'm gonna use that as my contour. It's very dark, so I'm gonna take the smallest amount. Mirror is useful. And that's going to go right in the hollow of my cheek, super lightly. And it's going to go in my temple as well. Just whatever is left on the brush is going in my temple. And jaw contour as well. And you also want it to go right into your hairline. It'll make it look less like makeup and more just like a shadow that your cheekbone is making. I'm going to take a smaller version of that same brush and do contour down my nose. Off a lot of the excess. And I'm going to bring it right up to my brow as well, just to tie it all together. And since we're going all out on contour today, just a little bit under my lower lip as well. Since we did so much contouring, we also want to do a little bit of highlighting. I wish that I had a matte, light skin tone. Fortunately, I do not, unless it's in liquid form. When I did powder, so let's not just do liquid on top of powder, that's a no-go. So I'm going to do Skimp from Urban Decay. And that's just going anywhere. anywhere the light would naturally hit. Down the nose, up the forehead. All right, and taking my Midnight Skin Finish in Light Year, and that's going to be the blushier bit of the highlight. And it looks like my lash glue is basically done drying, so I'm going to take Urban Decay 24/7 Liquid Waterproof Liner, and that's going to go over the band of the lashes just to hide it a little bit. We're going to tightline and waterline with just a black liner. Okay, so I think that's the look all done. I just used a little tiny touch of MAC Melba blush. And for lips, I used Urban Decay Lip Junkie in Midnight Cowboy, paired with Lise Wattier Lip Kiss Crayon Gloss in Melon Twist. Just a little bit of that in the center. I did my brows, and I think that is it. So thank you for watching, everyone, and I hope to try this look out. You can use whatever color you want for the pop of color in the outer corner. And it was great seeing you guys again. I hope you guys have a great day, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you wouldn't mind doing so down there. And also check out my Etsy shop. I haven't really been adding as many new items as I would like to, but there's still a whole lot of cool stuff in there, and I will link that in the description box as well. So I'll see you in my next video, and have a great day, guys. Bye. Eavesdropping on myself.